Hello friends, in this video tutorial lecture we will discuss the difference between discrete time Fourier transform and discrete Fourier transform. So we will start with what exactly the discrete time Fourier transform and how it is different from DFT. So in discrete Fourier transform we convert a discrete sequence xn into which is a time domain sequence into a frequency domain signal x of omega, where x of omega is given by the formula summation n is equal to minus infinity to infinity x of n e raised to power minus j omega n. Now remember, here the sequence xn is a periodic signal. That is why we have taken n is equal to minus infinity to infinity. So this sequence is converted into frequency domain signal x of omega. But in discrete time Fourier transform, this x of omega signal is continuous. The signal is continuous in nature. And whereas this input signal is also, this input signal is discrete. This input sequence is xn is discrete in nature. So in digital signal processing in various applications like linear filtering or speech processing or image processing, we require a signal. We require a signal x omega, which is in frequency domain, which is also discrete in nature, as well as this sequence x omega. This x omega should be a periodic sequence, and also it should be a discrete sequence. So we need to convert this continuous signal in frequency domain to a discrete signal, and one such method is sampling. We take sample at different time interval of this x of omega in order to convert the signal into a discrete signal. Let first take an example of DTFT. Let us take a signal, discrete signal xn, which is equal to a raised to power n un, where value of a is lie between 0 to 1. Now if you plot this signal xn, the plot of this signal xn is like this, because this value a lies from 0 to 1, it is a decreasing function. So for different value of n, this signal is a decreasing signal like this, and so on. So if we calculate x omega of this signal, which is equal to summation n is equal to minus infinity to infinity a raised to power n e raised to power minus j omega n, and then we calculate the magnitude spectrum of this sequence, which is the mod x of omega, which is given by 1 upon root of 1 minus 2a cos omega plus a square. Now if we plot this x of omega with respect to omega, the plot of x mod of x omega with respect to omega, this plot is continuous in nature. This plot is like this. It is periodic with the period 2 pi, and this plot is continuous in nature. But for different application of DSP, we want a frequency domain signal to be discrete in nature. So what we do here, we convert this frequency omega, we convert this frequency omega in discrete by taking samples. Now we are taking one time period from 0 to 2 pi, and we are taking, suppose, n, capital N samples. We are taking capital N samples. So this frequency 2 pi is divided with this capital N, and we are taking samples at different value of k, where k lies from 0 to n minus 1. So for k is equal to 0, we are taking first sample. For k is equal to 1, we are taking second sample, and for k is equal to 2, we are taking third sample, and so on. We are taking how many samples? We are taking capital N samples. So our frequency omega is now converted to this factor 2 pi by n into k, where 2 pi is the period of this sequence, frequency domain signal x omega. So our formula for now DFT is given as, remember, omega is replaced by this factor. So now this will be a function of k. So x of k can be now written as, now this sequence is not go from minus infinity to infinity, rather it will go from n is equal to 0 to n minus 1, because we are taking n samples of xn. So this is xn e raised to power minus j 2 pi by capital N into k into n. Remember what we did, we replaced this omega with the factor 2 pi by capital N into k. So this is how we calculate DFT by the help of DTFT. Now this xk will give us the discrete frequency samples rather than continuous frequency samples. Let us take one example, one such example to understand it more clearly. In this example, we take, suppose, x of n is equal to, given by 1 by 3 for n lies from 0 to 2 and 0 elsewhere. So for this example, if we calculate x of k, then again the formula for x of k is written over here, n is equal to 0 to n minus 1. Now our xn is 1 by 3 for 0 to n by 2. We will put this value later, e raised to power minus j 2 pi by capital N into kn. Remember, the value of capital N here is given, which is capital N value is also given, is equal to 4. So x of k is equal to summation. Now this xn lies from 0 to 2, so we'll take n is equal to 0 to n minus 1, which is 3. X of n is 1 by 3 e raised to power minus j 2 pi by capital N into k into n. Now we'll calculate this for different value of k. So for k is equal to 0, x of 0 is equal to summation n is equal to 0 to 3, 1 by 3, because this value will be, for k is equal to 0, this value will be equal to 1. So this is nothing but 1 by 3 plus 1 by 3 plus 1 by 3. So this will be equal to 1. Similarly, we'll calculate x of 1, which is n is equal to 0 to 3, 1 by 3 e raised to power minus j 2 pi by 4, which is minus j pi by 2 into k, which is 1, and n is goes from 0 to 3. So we can easily calculate this value, and this value comes out to be minus j by 3. Similarly, x of 2 we can calculate, it is 1 by 3, and x of 3, which is equal to j by 3. So overall, our xk sequence is given by 1 minus j by 3, 1 by 3, and j by 3. final answer. That's all for today's lecture. Thank you.